Hey guys, Camille here. So my phone is almost dead, so this won't be a very long live video for you guys, but I wanted to hop on my personal page for you guys because I think this is a topic that everybody could benefit from, not just my private community or my challengers. So I'm gonna keep it short and sweet, but hopefully you guys can hop on. I know it's not quite the end of the workday, but I wanted to hop on before I forgot and say hi if you do, and I will keep this up for you guys after the fact. So my title is, "But You're Not a Size Zero and You Don't Have Six-Pack Abs." I don't know if you guys have seen, but earlier this week I shared a progress picture from February to now, and I'm super excited with where I'm at and how I'm just gonna kind of maintain where I am now with certain tweaks and things that I'm doing on a daily basis. But I want you guys to know that you don't have to be a size zero and have six-pack abs to be happy in your own skin. Like, to me, I know that I will probably never be a size zero. I never was a size zero growing up, so how in the world could I revert back to that if I never was as a kid? And I don't really want six-pack abs because I love certain foods, and by eating those certain foods, it's kind of impossible to have six-pack abs. And shout out to everybody that is a size zero and is comfortable being a size zero and is comfortable with six-pack abs and is able to maintain that strict of a lifestyle. I just know that I would be setting myself up for failure if I did that. So I shared with you guys where I was super uncomfortable, didn't like how my clothes fit in February, to where I was at the end of July, where all my clothes were fitting again, my jeans were comfortable, I didn't have to live in yoga pants unless I wanted to, I didn't have to worry about putting a baggy sweatshirt on, as I felt comfortable in all the clothes that I had. And so I want you guys to know that it's okay if being a size zero is not your goal, or not having six-pack abs, or if you just want your clothes to fit again, if you just want to feel comfortable walking out of your door every single morning. Like, that is where I'm at right now. It took me a while to get here. I can honestly tell you guys, if I attempted to be a size zero or have six-pack abs, I would revert back completely to the anorexic tendencies that I used to have, and I never ever want to go back there. Like, I don't want to revisit those thought processes. I don't want to feel those emotions again. Like, I've moved on from those negative parts of my life, and I'm happy in the skin that I have now. I'm happy with the daily steps that I take to love myself and be happy with where I'm at and the daily tasks that I do. And my daily tasks are not that elaborate. My daily tasks are investing in myself, finding something, a book, a podcast, a YouTube video, a TV show, something that fills me up, makes me happy, know that I'm doing something that I enjoy because I want to do it, not because I have to do it. I know that I need to work out 5 to 7 days a week because that's when I feel most comfortable in my skin. That's when my mental state is where I want it to be. That is when I'm happy with where I am. And everybody's is gonna be different. If you guys are hopping on, say hi. I see people hopping on and off, so say hi if you're hopping on. I know that's what I need. My challengers have different ideal times, ideal amounts that they work out. Hi, Stacy. That they work out, and that's okay. But you need to find your ideal time, or amount that you work out. Hi, Danielle. So another part of me. Hi, Kirsty. Another part of me that makes me comfortable in my own skin and me being okay with where I am at today and maintaining this. Guys, I at the heaviest was a size 8. I typically hover around a 4. So I never got crazy big. I'm 5'2". I couldn't get crazy big. because I couldn't allow myself to do that. But because I would yo-yo, I would get to that size 6'8", I would go back to my anorexic tendencies, get back down to a 2-ish 4, and then go right back up. And it was just the yo-yoing back and forth, which was not good for my mental health, was not good for my body, and was not good for anyone around me because I was so crabby. I was not a very nice person. I put on this front that everything was okay, and I was miserable. And so by changing and finding those things that I needed to snap out of that yo-yoing and anorexic tendencies, to find what made me comfortable in my own skin. Yes, I am comfortable in a size small shirt and roughly a size 4 jeans. Is that going to be for everybody? Absolutely not. And that is okay, but you need to be okay and be open and honest with yourself that you're okay with that. That it's okay to be comfortable wherever you are comfortable. You should not let society or people around you tell you that you shouldn't be comfortable in a size 6, 8, 9, 10 pair of jeans. Whatever that size is for you, and it really doesn't have to be a size, it doesn't have to be a number on a scale. I really think it's a feeling and a mental mindset of where you're happy and where you're comfortable, but you are the only one that should decide that. You are the only one that holds that power. Society should not hold that power. Your significant others should not hold that power. Your friends should not hold that power. You are the one in control of what you're comfortable with. So I work out 5 days a week. I do something every day that makes me happy. And I try my best to eat as clean as possible. Do I still enjoy Mountain Dew? Absolutely. Guilty pleasure. I absolutely love it, especially when it's nice out in Minnesota. Do I enjoy adult beverages? Absolutely, because why in the world would I cut something out that I enjoy? Like, I don't think it's fair to restrict yourself so much that you're miserable with what you're doing. Do I enjoy cake and ice cream and whatever else when we have Axton or at family get-togethers and stuff? Absolutely. But the one thing I do not do anymore that I used to do is I do not guilt myself for enjoying things that are treats. I do not call them cheat meals. I do not call them cheat days. I do not call them anything like that, because that triggers my anxiety and my anorexic thoughts all over again. So why would I put myself in a situation that I know is going to spiral me backwards again? So I have learned that I live a life of balance. I teach my challengers a life of balance. I teach everyone in my free community gets tidbits on this, but I fully heartedly believe that we all can live a life that we want to live. So I think that it's so important to know what you need. Everything that I'm rattling off in this 10-minute video, or however long it ends up being, may not work for everybody, but that's what centered me. That's what made me work. Hi, Martinique. Yes, that's one of my guilty pleasures for sure. But that is, you need to do you. There are people out there that can help you. I don't know if you guys saw, but two of my posts this morning were awesome, exciting things for my current challengers. One just finished her first round of the 21-day fix and lost 11 pounds and 8 inches and is a busy mom getting ready to go back to school because she's in the education field and like just rocking it because she knew she needed to do something. She wasn't happy with where she was at, but she made the choice to find that balance, decide what she needed to do, and she rocked it. I had another one who works closer to 50, 60 hours a week at her jobs, and she decided she was going to train for her half marathon again. And so she ran almost 5 miles today without stopping, which was the furthest she's ever gone before without stopping. And she may work a whole bunch, and she may be cross training for this half marathon, but she's doing what she needs to do to create her perfect life. Hi, Katie! Create her perfect life. Create her, I really like her size zero or six-pack abs version. Like I was saying at the beginning, for those who just hop on, I'm not a size zero. I never have been, and I don't really want six-pack abs. So why would I strive for that? Instead, I'm striving for staying in that size four range and fitting in my small shirts because that's where I feel comfortable. That's where I'm confident walking out of our apartment door every single day. Or if I'm putting on a meeting at the Impact Learning Center, I'm comfortable up front of that meeting, not worrying about what clothes I have on, not worrying about how much makeup I have on, but knowing that I'm comfortable in my own skin. And I hope that that relays to everybody around me. I am spreading what I want to be spreading, not what society wants me to be spreading, not what the social media and everyone around me is saying that I should be doing. I think that it's so important that you guys understand that the media is out there to tell you that you're never going to be good enough because that's how they make money. They're out there to tell you that you should be focusing and moving for that next big and great thing. But from a girl in tiny town Minnesota, I would say you have to do what's best for you. You are the only one that can make that choice. You can reach out to resources to help you, like all of my challengers are doing right now. They're rocking it in our current group, working on mindset, routine, and finding stuff that works for them with the help of accountability and support and motivation. And you can do that too, but you are the one that needs to decide what your size zero and six pack abs is. Like, nobody else should. So my message to you guys is I have found what my ideal size zero and six pack abs version is for myself. Now I want you guys to do that for you. I want you guys to really sit down and think, what are you missing? What do you need help with? What do you need support with? What do you need motivation with to feel confident every time you walk out of your door and head to work or head out to the grocery store, whatever it may be? I want you guys to feel confident and happy and healthy every single day. And so that's my message for you guys today. Feel free to share it with whoever. I will make sure that it's public. And reach out to me if there's anything I can help with. You guys are rocking it. My challengers are rocking it. And I just think that there needs to be more of that out there. Getting those two messages this morning about how they're really seeing changes within anywhere from 21 to 45 days is super heartwarming and super exciting. And I just honestly love those changes that they've made and that I've made myself. So have a happy Wednesday. My phone's about to die, and I will check in with you guys later. If I can help in any way, shape, or form, please reach out, and have a wonderful rest of your night.